Hello, Leo listeners. Cara here from leolistening.com, where I help intrepid travelers and adventurous expats improve their English listening skills so they can better connect with native speakers. So, I should probably add like a caveat to the title of this video. So the first thing to say is I have no problem with slow talking YouTube teachers. So when you teach a language for a living, your job is to make it accessible. So that means talking in a more slow and clear way. When I trained to teach English, I had to learn to explain things as simply as possible and find ways to check my students' understanding without just saying, "Do you understand?" So when I speak normally to English learners, in other words, fast without articulating properly like I would to friends or family, I feel like I'm going against my profession. To clarify further, if you want to learn a grammar point or some new vocabulary and you prefer watching YouTube to picking up a book, then a slow talking YouTube teacher is exactly what you need, in fact. If a teacher is explaining a complicated grammar point while talking fast, not articulating properly and using a bunch of slang, then they're not doing their job properly. It's as simple as that. But if you want to understand native speakers when they talk fast and you want to speak in the same way, then you need to listen to fast, messy spoken English. So listening to slow talking YouTube teachers will not help you if that's your goal. They will help you if you want to learn more grammar or vocabulary or learning strategies, but that's it. It's the same reason I discourage people from listening to any kind of academic monologue. So for example, TED Talks. So this is a slow monologue with a presentation, with visuals. It's not a fast dialogue between two or more English speakers, which is what I think you want to understand. Documentaries. I love watching documentaries, but most documentaries are slow monologues on top of images. And I know they're not all the same, but again, if your goal is to understand fast conversational English, you won't hear much of that in a typical documentary. The news is another example. So yes, some broadcasters do speak fast, but again, this is a monologue with plenty of images and text to help you understand. It's not a conversation. Certain podcasts. So the best podcasts for improving your conversational English listening skills are interview podcasts between two or more speakers. But not all podcasts are like this. Some podcasts are monologues. Some are more like the news or a documentary in style. So just be careful and where possible, try to listen to podcasts that are conversational and interview style. Audiobooks also. I love listening to audiobooks, but the problem is that audiobooks are slower than real conversation. So even if your book is fiction and it contains dialogue, the narrator probably won't read it at real conversational speed, just because audiobooks tend to be slower, because that's the style in audiobooks. So to come back to YouTube teachers, so if the YouTube teacher makes a video of themselves or a video of them talking fast with another native English speaker, then that can help, right? Especially if they take the time to break down their speech afterwards and explain why it was so hard to catch. And that's what they would do if they were a listening specialist, right? But if they're just explaining grammar, like in the typical YouTube video, or pronunciation mistakes, or who knows what, then they probably won't be speaking fast. It doesn't matter if they're a native speaker. No native speaker will ever talk to you like a YouTube teacher in the street. It's not going to happen. So if your goal is to understand fast English, then you need to go out and listen to it. And your efforts will be rewarded, because once you understand that type of speech better, you'll catch and pick up new expressions and reinforce your grammar knowledge. So that's right, you won't have to come to YouTube and listen to slow-talking teachers explain grammar and vocabulary. You can use your improved listening skills to pick up the grammar and vocab naturally. So here's what you can do instead. You can listen to material that is more conversational, fast. So I've got a few recommendations for you. So the first one is interviews. So I mentioned podcasts that are interviews. That's one possibility. Or you could use talk shows. So I love using interviews from the Ellen Show or other similar talk shows like Saturday Night Live, because Ellen and the other hosts, they use, and their guests use real fast-spoken English. So you could, and you could also listen, if your YouTube teachers bring on, you know, guests to interview, that that might be a possibility as well. Depends how they're speaking, depends if the guest is another teacher or a native English speaker. And my other recommendation is movies and TV shows. So I love helping my students with movies and TV shows because of the motivation factor. So it's much easier to get people to do difficult listening tasks like dictations when they're watching something they enjoy, right? That's half the battle, in my opinion. And also the dialogue in movies and TV shows can be quite similar to real life dialogue. And in some cases, it's actually harder than what you would hear in real life. So it's good practice for real life encounters, which might actually be a bit easier. So sometimes it is good to train with something harder and really push yourself, and then you'll find that in the real situation, it's not actually quite so bad. So the key to going beyond just listening and actually understanding and using fast spoken English in your own speech is to have some text. So that can be a transcript or subtitles. And when you have a text, you can check your understanding. You can do dictations. And the best situation of all is when you can work with a teacher who can explain to you why you didn't catch what you missed and break down all the little details of fast spoken English for you. So to sum up, keep listening to slow talking YouTube teachers if you want, but don't come and complain to me when you can't understand native speakers when they talk to you in the street. So teacher English and real English are often two very different things, and you can't prepare for real life by just listening to YouTube teachers. It's like training for a marathon by doing just a couple of laps around the park. You're going to hurt yourself and you're going to be disappointed. So if you like that analogy and the rest of the video, give it a like and give me and my channel a subscribe. Also, if you scroll down to the description, you can download my mini movie guide where I teach you how to understand fast spoken English with movies. And when you sign up for that, you'll also join my email list where you'll get regular updates and tips from me on catching fast conversational English. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.